the word constellation doesn't actually describe these different images we've been seeing on the dome. They're actually called asterisms. An asterism is just an image that we've created playing connect the dots with the different stars in the sky. So the Little Dipper is an asterism. The Big Dipper, it's also an asterism, and it's an asterism within another asterism called Ursa Major. There are countless asterisms that our ancestors from many different cultures have created over the thousands of years that we have existed. So, when you hear the sentence, "all the constellations in the sky," this is an image that you might think of. But when an astronomer thinks of the sentence, "all the constellations in the sky," this is actually what they envision. An astronomical constellation is actually a border region, almost like a map dividing a continent into countries. Now here are the actual astronomical constellations of Ursa Major and Ursa Minor. Now where did all these asterisms come from in the first place? As we saw earlier, the Big Dipper could be used to find Polaris and help find out our different directions. Mapping the night sky is almost like creating a map, because night after night, the constellations appear pretty much in the exact same spot. Our ancestors would look at these different images that they created in the night sky and spin whimsical stories about what they were, why they moved to the night sky, how they affected each other, and how they even affected people on Earth. Now, the wilder the story that they would tell, the more easily they could remember it. And some of these stories that they told became so important that they got incorporated into their time-honored spiritual practices.